Hello, welcome to Arvind Singh Academy. We are discussing matrix and determinants and this is lecture number 4. I hope you have already watched part 1 to part 3 before watching part 4. In this lecture, I am going to discuss about some characteristics of transpose of matrices and thereafter we will discuss some elementary row transformation as well. So, transpose of matrix. As we have already learned about the transpose of matrix, that rows and columns are interchanged in matrix is called transpose of matrix. But transpose of matrices we have already learned and their characteristics as well, that transpose of A whole transpose is equal to A hota hai, A plus B transpose is equal to A transpose plus B transpose hota hai, A B का whole transpose is equal to B transpose A transpose होता है. ये सब हम प्रूफ कर चुके हैं कि A transpose is equal to K times of A transpose होता है और A inverse का transpose is equal to A transpose का inverse होता है. ठीक है ना? तो ये transpose और फिर इसका inverse होता है. तो ये सब चीजें हम लोगों ने सीख लिया है और hopefully आप ये बात आप भी समझ गए होंगे. Now on the basis of transpose, there are some other characteristics of matrices that is called symmetric and skew symmetric matrices. So we have to learn symmetric and skew symmetric matrices. Symmetric and skew symmetric matrices. Skew symmetric matrices. What is that? Symmetric and skew symmetric matrices. So first of all, I am going to discuss about the symmetric matrices. Symmetric matrices. Right? If A be any square matrix, if A be any square matrix such that A transpose is equal to A, then A is called symmetric matrix. Symmetric matrix. A is called symmetric matrix. Right? For example, A is a matrix A. Now this is 3, 4, 5, 4, 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Now, if I could take A transpose, then what will happen? First row to be right in first column, 3, 4, 5. Second row to be right in second column, so 4, 5, 6. And third row to be right in third column, so 5, 6, 7. And in this way, you will find that there is no change. So that will remain A itself. And therefore, A is symmetric matrix. So symmetric matrix. Right, you can take another example even. Suppose I can take here another example like P is a matrix and this is A H G H G B F F C like this. Now if I would take P transpose, then what will happen? A H G first row to be right in first column, H B F that is second row to be right in second column, and GFC that is third row to be right in third column. So that is again same thing. So this would be P and therefore P is a symmetric matrix. So symmetric and skew symmetric matrices can be determined by using this. P is a symmetric matrix, right now. And now what is the characteristic of symmetric matrix? Can you observe this? What is the observation? Observation is, this is only possible if matrix is of order m into n, then transpose it will be n into m. And similarly, if aij, say a be any matrix of element aij of order m into m, say a square matrix always, is a symmetric matrix. If condition is symmetric matrix, if Aij is equal to Aji, Aij is equal to Aji, then only for all i, then only it is possible. that is elements. This elements belong to second row, first column, and elements belong to first row and second column would be same. First row, second column, and second row, first column will be same. Similarly, the elements belong to second row and third column here, and second row and third column, or even first row, third column, and third row, first column, they should be same. Similarly, if I say that second row, third column is this, and third row, second column is this, that will be also same. So here, the elements Aij is equal to Aji for all I is equal to j, then matrix is said to be symmetric matrix. That is the mathematical aspect of this phenomena. That symmetric matrix Aij must be equal to Aji for all ij. A11, A22, A33 will remain same, because A22 and A22, even order will change, that will not make any difference. Now, what about skew symmetric? So, what about skew symmetric? So, in a skew symmetric matrix, what is that? Skew symmetric matrix. If A be any square matrix, such that A transpose is equal to minus of A. A transpose is minus of A, then A is called skew symmetric. Called skew symmetric matrix. Skew symmetric matrix. Right? A is called skew symmetric matrix. For example, if there is a like this 0, 1, minus 1, 0. And what about A transpose? Then A transpose is equal to first row to be right in first column, second row to be right in second column. And what will be that? That is minus, if I would take common, that will be 0, 1, minus 1, 0. And this is what? Nothing else but A. And therefore, A is skew symmetric matrix. It is nothing else but A. And therefore, A is skew symmetric matrices. So we can write A is skew symmetric matrices. Skew. Symmetric matrix. A is skew symmetric matrix. So in a skew symmetric matrix, a matrix Aij will be skew symmetric if what? Aij must be equal to minus of Aji for all I is equal to I and j. Aji must be equal to minus Aji. And that what you have seen here. So characteristics will be like this, and this is the mathematical formulation of skew symmetric matrices. You can write it like this: the Aij must be equal to Aji, like this. So this is the characteristics, and you can take it like this: Aij must be equal to minus of Aji. Now, one question usually they ask prove that diagonal elements of skew symmetric matrices is always zero. Diagonal elements of skew symmetric matrices is always zero. Prove that diagonal elements of skew symmetric matrix is always zero. So solution is what? Let us write solution. In skew symmetric matrix, what happened? Aij must be equal to minus of aji. This employee aij plus aji is equal to 0. For diagonal elements, I is equal to j. But for diagonal elements, I is equal to j, and therefore aii plus aii is equal to 0. This employee 2aii is equal to 0. This employee aii is equal to 0. And aii is what? These are the diagonal elements. So therefore, diagonal elements of skew symmetric matrices is always 0. Right? There are some other questions that can be generated from symmetric properties, and what is that? The question is, prove that every square matrix can be represented as sum of symmetric and skew symmetric matrices. Sum of symmetric and skew symmetric matrices. This is what the question, and that we need to write the answer. So solution, how we can let A be any square matrix. A be any square matrix such that A can be written as A plus A transpose plus A minus A transpose and whole divided by 2. That further can be written as A plus A transpose by 2 and A minus A transpose by 2. That is P plus Q say. Right? One of them is considered as P and another is as Q. How A can be written like this? Plus A transpose minus A transpose will be cancelled out. A plus A become 2A and 2A divided by 2 will be A. So this can be written like this. Now that can be split into two different sum of matrices. A plus A transpose by 2, that is considered as matrix P, and A minus A transpose by 2, that is considered as Q. Now, if I prove one of them as symmetric and other one as skew symmetric, then we can easily say that square matrix can be represented in sum of symmetric and skew symmetric. So, A, this one is P. Now, P transpose, how can we judge about any matrix will be symmetric or non-symmetric or skew symmetric? Just by taking transpose. So, since P is equal to, what is P? A plus A transpose by 2. Now I can take P transpose, and using this P transpose, what will be P transpose? A plus A transpose by 2 whole transpose, and that is 1 by 2 A plus A transpose whole transpose, since K A transpose is equal to K times of A transpose. K will come out as a scalar, so 1 by 2 come out as a scalar. Now 1 by 2 A transpose plus A transpose whole transpose. Since what is the characteristics? A plus B transpose can be written as A transpose plus B transpose. Now what is that? A transpose plus A. Why? Since A transpose whole transpose is equal to A. And therefore 1 by 2 A plus A transpose, that can be also written. Since in matrix A plus B is equal to B plus A, conformal for addition, then they must be commutative. Now this is what? Nothing else but P, and therefore we can write P is a symmetric matrix. Now what about Q? So to find what about Q, we can write here let Q is equal to half A plus A transpose A minus A transpose by 2. Q is nothing else but A minus A transpose by 2. So therefore Q transpose is equal to A minus A transpose by 2 whole transpose. That is 1 by 2 A minus A transpose whole transpose. That is 1 by 2 A transpose minus A transpose whole transpose. Right? And that you must write the characteristics why I have written similar like what I have written in the earlier section. So you should write like this. Right? Okay. So 1 by 2 A transpose minus A, and that if I would take minus common, it will be A minus A transpose, and this is nothing else but minus of Q, and Q transpose is minus of Q, and therefore Q is a SQ symmetric matrix. SQ symmetric matrix. Right? Matrix. Q is a SQ symmetric matrix. P is symmetric, Q is SQ symmetric, and therefore from first A is equal to P by Q. One of them is symmetric, other is SQ symmetric, and therefore every square matrix can be represented as sum of symmetric and skew symmetric matrices. Symmetric and skew symmetric matrices. I hope you got it. Okay. Now there is another question related to this. Question is, if A and B are symmetric matrices, then prove that first AB plus BA is symmetric matrix, and AB minus BA is SQ symmetric matrix. Right. So this is what we have to discuss. So AB plus BA is symmetric. We have to prove this. A and B are, what is given? Given that solution. Given that A and B are symmetric matrices. Symmetric matrix. And therefore A transpose must be equal to A and B transpose must be equal to B. This is equation 1. Now we have to find AB plus BA. Now AB plus BA transpose is equal to what? That can be written as AB transpose plus BA transpose. AB transpose can be written as B transpose A transpose. And this is A transpose B transpose. Why? Because order will reverse. A B transpose is equal to B transpose A transpose. So that is why. Now B transpose is what? B transpose is B. A, B transpose is B, A transpose is A, A transpose is A, and B transpose is B. Now A, since addition is commutative, so I can take it like AB plus BA as well, and this is what? The same thing, and therefore A plus BA is symmetric matrix, because after taking transpose they won't change, right? Now matrices, they are a similar function. AB plus BA transpose is same as AB plus BA, and therefore AB plus BA is symmetric matrix. Now in similar way we can go ahead for AB minus BA part 2. Right now this is part 1. ए बी माइनस बी ए ट्रांसपोज इज इक्वल टू ए बी ट्रांसपोज माइनस बी ए ट्रांसपोज इन द सिमिलर फैशन दैट विल बी डी ट्रांसपोज ए ट्रांसपोज एंड दैट विल बी ए ट्रांसपोज बी ट्रांसपोज दैट इज ऑल्सो बी ट्रांसपोज इज नथिंग एल्स बट बी ए ट्रांसपोज ए ट्रांसपोज ए एंड बी ट्रांसपोज इज बी एंड इफ आई टुक निगेटिव साइन देन ए बी विल कम अर्लियर ए बी माइनस बी ए So this is negative of AB minus BA will come, and therefore, as the properties of skew symmetric matrices, we can write AB minus BA is what? Skew symmetric matrix. So this is the characteristics, right? I hope you got it. And this is what proof of this question. Now let us solve one question. Question is. Express A is any matrix of like this A is 3, 3, minus 1 and minus 2, minus 2, 1 and minus 4, minus 5, 1 as sum of symmetric and skew symmetric matrices So what we'll write? To start solution of this question, we need to write first A transpose. Right now? A transpose we need to write. So A transpose is equal to what will happen? 3, 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 2, 1, and minus 4, minus 5, 1. This is what A transpose. And we will write here that we know We know that a square matrix can be represented as sum of symmetric and skew symmetric as A is equal to A plus A transpose by 2 and A minus A transpose by 2 where A plus A by 2 transpose by 2 is symmetric and A minus A transpose by 2 is skew symmetric, right? And therefore, we will write now A plus A transpose. What is A plus A transpose by 2? That is A is matrix like A is 3, 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 2, 1. 3, 3, minus 1, 3, 3, minus 1, and then minus 2, minus 2, 1, minus 2, minus 2, 1, and minus 4, minus 5, 1, minus 4, minus 5, 1, minus 4, minus 5, 1, and A transpose is nothing else but 3, 3, minus 1, and minus 2, minus 2, 1, and minus 4, minus 5, 1. So that is a transpose, and whole divided by 2. So we can write a bracket as well. We can write here, this is your 1 by 2 and this whole divided by 2. So we can write 1 by 2, this is 3 plus 3 is 6, 3 plus minus 2 1, minus 1 minus 4 minus 5, and minus 2 minus 2 plus 3 is 1, and minus 2 minus 2 minus 4, and 1 plus minus 5 minus 4, and minus 4 minus 1 minus 5, and minus 5 minus 1 minus 4, and 1 plus 1 is 2. So if I could write here divided by 2, then what will come? And if you divide by 2, the thing will come like 6 divided by 2 is 3, and this is 1 by 2, minus 5 by 2, 1 by 2, minus 2, minus 2, minus 5 by 2, minus 2, and 1. So this is one part, say one part. And now A minus A transpose by 2, also we can write A minus A transpose by 2, that is 1 by 2 of A minus A transpose. What is that? A is 3, 3 minus 1. 3, 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 2, 1, minus 4, minus 5, 1, and A transpose is nothing else but 3, 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 2, 1, and minus 4, minus 5, 1. So now what will come? If I would subtract, then things will come like 1 by 2, and 3 minus 3, 0. 3 minus 2, 3 minus minus 2 is 5, minus 1 minus plus 4 is 3, and minus 2 minus 3 minus 5, right, minus 2 minus 3 minus 5, minus 2 plus 2 0, and 1 plus 5 is 6, and minus 4 plus 1 minus 3, and this is minus 5 minus 1 minus 6. And this is 1 minus 1, 0. So that is like this. And if you divide by 2, what will come? Then this will be 0, 5 by 2, 3 by 2, minus 5 by 2, 0, 3, minus 3 by 2, minus 3, 0. Now, if I could add these two, then will it come like A? So this is 2 part 2, and therefore A can be written as, therefore A is what? Nothing else but A is 3, 3 minus 1, 3, 3 minus 1, minus 2, minus 2, 1, minus 4, minus 5, 1, can be written as sum of symmetric and skew symmetric, symmetric and skew symmetric, plus skew symmetric. This is 0, 5 by 2, 3 by 2, minus 5 by 2, 0, 3, minus 3 by 2, minus 3, 0. This one, and symmetric part is like 3, 1 by 2, minus 5 by 2. 3, 1 by 2, minus 5 by 2, and 1 by 2, minus 2, minus 2, 1 by 2, minus 2, minus 2, and minus 5 by 2, minus 2, 1, minus 5 by 2, minus 2, and 1. Do you find this sum is correct? Let us see. 3 plus 0 is 3, right? Minus 5 by 2, 1 by 2 is 6 by 2, that is 3. 3 by 2 minus 5 by 2 is minus 2 by 2, that is minus 1. Minus 5 by 2 plus 1 by 2 minus 4 by 2, that is minus 2. 0 plus minus 2 is minus 2. 3 minus 2 is 1, that is also correct. Minus 5 by 2 minus 3 by 2 minus 8 by 2, that is minus 4. Minus 2, minus 3, minus 5, and 1 plus 0 is 1. So every term is correct and we have checked it. So therefore, this is the solution of this question. And therefore, a square matrix. matrix can be represent इसमें ये क्या है, ये है सिमेट्रिक और ये है एक्सक्लूसिव मैट्रिक। हम ये कहें तो ये क्या है सिमेट्रिक, ये है इसमें सिमेट्रिक सिमेट्रिक मैट्रिक्स और ये क्या है एक्सक्लूसिव मैट्रिक सिमेट्रिक मैट्रिक्स ना। तो इस तरह से ये है स्क्वायर मैट्रिक्स, क्यों, क्योंकि रो ऑर्डर और नंबर ऑफ रो या नंबर ऑफ कॉलम सेम। तो इस तरह से हमने ये रिप्रेजेंट कर दिया एंड दस स्क्वायर मैट्रिक्स कैन बी रिप्रेजेंट एज सम ऑफ सिमेट्रिक एंड एक्सक्लूसिमेट्रिक। सो आई होप यू गॉट इट। सिमेट्रिक की इतनी प्रॉपर्टीज है, इसको अच्छे से याद कर लेना है, ठीक है, और याद करके और इसके क्वेश्चन कर लेना है। अगली बार जब हम मिलते हैं ब्रेक के बाद तो फिर हम बात करेंगे आगे कि माइनस को फैक्टर्स क्या होते हैं और एलिमेंट्री रो ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन भी क्या होता है, ठीक है। सो टिल देन बाय बाय, गॉड ब्लेस यू।